This is Spanish audio lessons for complete beginners. Lessons 6 to 10. Written by Maria Fernandez. Narrated by Maria Fernandez, Susana Cortés, Carlos Díaz, Arancha Gutiérrez, Daniel Gutiérrez, and Unai Urrastavaso. You can get the ebook transcript of these Spanish audio lessons on all ebook platforms. You can find the links at kerapido.com. That's kerapido.com. Kerapido.com. At kerapido.com, you can also find the interactive Spanish online course with the dialogues featured in these lessons. Lesson 6. In this lesson, we are going to hear a dialogue at the hotel. We are going to practice the new words with the audio flashcards. We are going to learn how to describe el nouns. And finally, we are going to learn about the silent age. Dialogue. We are going to hear this lesson's dialogue twice.
Tiene reservada una habitación individual con baño para tres noches.
Eso es. ¿Puedo mandar un mensaje por correo electrónico?
Sí. Hay un ordenador en la cafetería.
Ah, ¿y me puede dar la llave de mi habitación?
Aquí tiene. Tiene reservada una habitación individual con baño para tres noches.
Eso es. ¿Puedo mandar un mensaje por correo electrónico?
Sí. Hay un ordenador en la cafetería.
Ah, ¿y me puede dar la llave de mi habitación?
Aquí tiene.
And here is the dialogue with its translation.
Tiene reservada una habitación individual con baño para tres noches.
You have a single room with bathroom reserved for three nights.
Eso es. ¿Puedo mandar un mensaje por correo electrónico?
That's it. Can I send a message by email?
Sí, hay un ordenador en la cafetería.
Yes, there is a computer in the cafeteria.
Ah, ¿y me puede dar la llave de mi habitación?
Oh, and can you give me my room key?
Aquí tiene.
Here you are. Vocabulary audio flashcards. Now we are going to hear the 16 new words that came up in the dialogue together with their translation. Reservada, reserved. La habitación, the room, the bedroom. Individual, single, individual. Con, with. El baño, the bathroom. Para, for. Eso, that. Mandar, to send. El mensaje, the message. El correo, the email, the post. Electrónico, electronic. Hay, there is, there are. El ordenador, the computer. Puede, you can. Dar, to give. La llave, the key. Let's now practice saying those 16 new words. I'll say them in English. Can you say them to me in Spanish? There is, there are. Hay, the room, the bedroom. La habitación, for. Para, the key. La llave, the bathroom. El baño, the message. El mensaje, to give. Dar, reserved. Reservada, single, individual. Individual, with. Con, the computer. El ordenador, to send. Mandar, you can.
puede. That. Eso. The email, the post. El correo. Electronic. Electrónico. Now that we are familiar with the new words, let's hear the dialogue once more. Can you repeat each line after the native speakers?
Tiene reservada una habitación individual con baño para tres noches.
Eso es. ¿Puedo mandar un mensaje por correo electrónico?
Sí, hay un ordenador en la cafetería.
Ah, ¿y me puede dar la llave de mi habitación?
Aquí tiene.
Spanish grammar. In this lesson, we are going to learn how to describe el nouns. In lesson 3, we saw that the word el, the, is used before masculine nouns. Now we are going to see how you describe those masculine nouns. Here are two examples. El teléfono negro, the black telephone. El pasaporte marrón, the brown passport. Unlike in English, describing words in Spanish usually come after the noun they describe. Compare these examples with their translations. El teléfono azul, the blue telephone. El pasaporte negro, the black passport. El baño marrón, the brown bathroom. Important notes. Describing words don't change their endings to O or E to match the ending of a masculine noun. For example, el teléfono marrón, el pasaporte marrón. El teléfono negro, el pasaporte negro. Marrón and negro are the forms used with all masculine nouns. Changing the ending of a word describing a masculine noun can make it difficult for native speakers to understand what you're saying. To illustrate these points, here are six examples. El teléfono es marrón. The telephone is brown. El teléfono marrón es mío. The brown telephone is mine. El pasaporte es negro. The passport is black. El pasaporte negro es mío. The black passport is mine. El baño es azul. The bathroom is blue. El baño azul es mío. The blue bathroom is mine. To practice what we've learned, can you say the following 10 sentences in Spanish? I'll give you the answer after you tell me. The telephone is blue. El teléfono es azul. The black passport is mine. El pasaporte negro es mío. The blue telephone is mine. El teléfono azul es mío. The passport is blue. El pasaporte es azul. The bathroom is brown. El baño es marrón. The brown bathroom is mine. El baño marrón es mío. The brown telephone is mine. El teléfono marrón es mío. The passport is black. El pasaporte es negro. The telephone is black. El teléfono es negro. The telephone is brown. El teléfono es marrón.
In this lesson, I've shown you how to describe el nouns.
In the next few lessons, I'm going to show you how to describe la, los and las nouns. That's going to give your Spanish a big push, but using describing words correctly takes practice and patience. For a while, you're going to make many mistakes, even basic mistakes. But don't get discouraged. Every minute of practice is going to make a difference. For example, repeat the drills in this lesson until you can get all the sentences right easily. Go back to the dialogues you've heard so far in these audio lessons and try to spot the describing words. The more Spanish you listen to and the more speaking drills you do, the faster you'll master describing words. When doing speaking drills, make sure you say your sentences out loud, as if you were talking to me. That will help you master describing words even faster. If you want to hear more dialogues and do more listening and speaking drills, have a look at my Spanish online course. To find out all about it, go to my website, querapido.com/course.
Spanish pronunciation. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the silent age. This is what the Spanish H plus vowel sounds like when said by a native speaker. Please repeat after me. A, E, I, O, U. The Spanish H is silent. It is totally silent both at the beginning of a word and between vowels. Often it will be tempting to say it like in English. Unfortunately, doing so will make it difficult for Spanish speakers to understand you. For instance, make sure you never say the H like in the English words hotel or alcohol. Listen to these five Spanish words which look very similar in English but don't sound exactly the same. Hotel, hospital, horizontal, horrible, histórico. Let's now practice saying these five words. Repeat them after me. Hotel, hospital, horizontal, horrible, histórico. And here are four words with the letter H from these courses' dialogues. Repeat after me. Hola, hasta, habitación, hay. Let's hear the dialogue one last time.
Tiene reservada una habitación individual con baño para tres noches.
Eso es. ¿Puedo mandar un mensaje por correo electrónico?
Sí, hay un ordenador en la cafetería.
Ah, ¿y me puede dar la llave de mi habitación?
Aquí tiene.
Spanish learning tip. One of the most difficult things when you're learning a foreign language is to find the motivation to get going. You'll often feel that you're wasting your time, not getting anywhere, or even forgetting most of what you've learned. The idea of giving up will often be on the back of your mind. This is perfectly natural. To get rid of these negative thoughts, give your mind a positive learning environment. Here are some ideas. If you like magazines, get a subscription to the Spanish language version of your favorite publication. If you like movies or TV series, you can get your favorite one with Spanish subtitles and even a Spanish soundtrack. If you like reading, children's books in Spanish are a great way to learn. If you like music, listen to Latin music and get the lyrics. Extra Spanish learning tip. I want to share with you my top language learning secret. I've been studying foreign languages since I was a teenager, and today I can learn a lot faster than I ever imagined. I believe the main reason why I've been making such great progress with German, Italian and Portuguese is because I've been focusing on listening rather than watching. Listening to audiobooks and podcasts instead of watching videos or films will put your Spanish learning on steroids. At first, it's going to be frustrating, very frustrating. You're going to understand next to nothing, but the trick is to keep listening. Just keep listening. And listen to the same recording many times. Don't be tempted to move from one recording to another. Instead, stick to one recording for a while. That's going to make all the difference to your progress. That's how I learned a lot of the English I know today, by listening to the same recordings over and over. Listening to Spanish regularly will help you expand your vocabulary really fast. You'll become familiar with the verbs in a natural way. You'll learn the word order, intonation, common expressions, and overall, you'll become comfortable and confident with the language. When learning Spanish, the reason why listening to a recording is so much more effective than watching a video is because when you look at images, you rely on the body language of the actors and the visual setting to understand a situation. When you watch a video, you can understand a lot of the action without necessarily understanding the words. But when all you have is a recording with no body language and no visual setting, you focus on the words, because that's all you have. And by focusing on the words, you start noticing common expressions, verb forms, and frequent words. The more you listen to recordings, the more familiar you'll become with those expressions, verb forms, and frequent words, and the faster you learn new ones. I want to encourage you to listen to Spanish as much as you can, and as often as you can, even if you only understand a few words here and there. For example, subscribe to a free podcast. There are hundreds of them. Make sure you choose a topic you like a lot. Listen to a few minutes of an episode and see if you can understand anything, anything at all. Then listen to the same recording a few more times. Notice how the second and third time you can understand a bit more. When I was learning English, I remember listening to recordings where I could hardly understand anything. Every time I could make up a new word, it felt like a great achievement. Enjoy the challenge of understanding next to nothing at first, and celebrate every little improvement you make.
This is the end of Lesson 6.